Okay, how is everyone? Today we're going to be just looking over this one question, which is related to limits. So the question is, which limit expressions agree with the graph? So what it's asking is it wants us to go through all these answer choices and see whatever fits with the graph over here. So we're going to first look at A. So A says, the limit as x approaches negative 2 of function g of x is equal to 6. So we have to check the graph for this. So we're going to be looking, as you can see, it says x approaches negative 2. So we're going to be going on the x-axis and we're going to find negative 2. And then now we're going to follow the graph from the left and the right to see if what it's stating is correct. So if we're going to look from the left, we're going to go following, following, following. And then, yeah, it gets to 6. So that is accurate. So the limit for negative 2 from the right is 6, but now we have to look, or sorry, from the left, and now we have to look at the right. So we're going to follow the graph on the right side, and when we get there, lock it to the y-axis, and we see it's 4. So these two, the left and the right, are not equal to one another. Therefore, the limit is not 6. It means that the limit does not exist. So A is not the answer. Okay, that was an X, sorry. Now we're gonna look at answer choice B. So same thing as x approaches negative 2, but the difference is from the left. So we already looked at it from the left. We said that when you're looking at it from the left, you're going, and then you see at the y-axis what it is, it's 6. Therefore, B is correct. Now, see the difference between these two questions. They could look similar, and you could say, but why is this one this and this one not this? So the reason is A, it's asking for negative 2 as a whole. It's not saying from the left or from the right. And when it doesn't state exactly which one, that means you have to look at both sides. And if both sides aren't equal to each other, then it does not exist. So we already saw that when we went through it. But with B, they state that you see this negative sign, like next to the number, that means they want to see it from the left. They want the limit from the left only. It doesn't matter about the right or anything about that. It's just the left. We're only concerned with the left side. Therefore, even though this other side doesn't match the other one, it's not important to the question because we're not looking at the other side. Therefore, B is correct. Now we can look at C. And we already know D is wrong because B is correct, so you can cancel that out. So limit as x approaches 0 from the right, as you can see with this plus sign, of function g of x, it doesn't exist. So we're gonna go to 0, and that's just in the middle over here. And we're gonna look at it from the right. So we're just gonna go, 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 go until we get to 0. And then it's saying it doesn't exist. However, it does exist. It's 0. On the y-axis, it's 0. So the limit of 0 from the right would be 0, and that contradicts what it's saying. It's saying it doesn't exist, but it does. It's 0. So this is wrong as well. Therefore, B is our only answer of this question. I hope you all understood, and if you have any questions, you can ask me about them.